Hi there and welcome to Total War Rome Remastered Merchant Guide. Today I will tell you guys what is a merchant, because he's a new mechanic and a new unit in the game, and how he works. I saw a lot of people are using the auto manage, but today I will explain to you guys how to use properly merchants and what are the things which you need to do with your merchant. To start things off, let's speak about what is a merchant and what is his purpose in general. I know some people will say obviously his purpose is to make gold, however, yes, but technically merchant is not a unit, he is a trade route link. So to make a merchant, we need to have at least market in our settlement and we can recruit a merchant. Merchant is limited, one unit per level of market you have, and you can have maximum three merchants which are connected to the settlement. As we said before, merchant is not a unit. Technically, merchant is a link. He is like making another port for your settlement. To check how merchants are making money, you cannot go under the tab of the settlement to see the income or the trade import-export. You have to go into financial overview of your whole faction. And here you have the merchants. As you guys can see, I already have one merchant which is doing his job. He is from Aretium and he is in Cyprus. So let's go over here. And see, my merchant is in Cyprus and he is making me 25 ducats. And just by having him here in Salamis, it is like I'm neighboring the settlements on its own. I would also highly advise you guys to check the previous video where we spoke about how trading system works, because there we explained what is a direct link and what does the port means. And you will see the power of it as we go through this video. Second part is, how do these merchants actually work? We can see that we have merchant here and he is making a pathetic amount of ducat, which is completely useless for us. So there are several things which we will go through to explain the mechanics of the merchant. First is distance, second is resource, third one is value, fourth one is trade agreement, and the fifth one is monopolization of the merchant. Let's go one by one through these so you can get a better picture of what actually happens. How far you go from your settlement, from your merchant settlement, is one aspect of having a good trade link. It is not crucial, however, it is highly advisable that your merchant is far, far away from your home settlement. That way, he will make more money because the value of resource will go up. This, as I said at the start, is not crucial. However, since you have a limited number of merchants, it is highly advisable that you go a little bit further to some key settlements and try to get most out of your merchant. If distance is not crucial for your merchant, resources are. Resources are the things which are actually giving you the value which you are trading. So if you have in your home settlement iron, and you go and you position your merchant in a settlement where they have iron, you will have less income because you already have that resource. So the best thing to do is to go to the settlement, to go to the province, which has resources which you don't have. Again, we are here in Salamis, and here we have purple dye, we have gold, we have copper, and we have timber. These are all resources which I don't have in Aretium, and by default my merchant will make much more money because he will basically link all of these things back to my home region which I don't have. And if we go here under the merchant, we can see this income. To add app to the second advice of resources, its value. As we said, resources are the things which are giving value. So it is natural that after the first two advices where we said go far and pick the province where you don't have those resources in your home region, pick resources which are in high value. Again, here we have copper, we have timber, we have gold, and we have purple dye. So these resources are giving us huge amount of value as they are the resources with higher tier. So try to pick resources and regions which you don't have in your home region, but which are higher tier on the list of all of the resources in the game. Now we need to speak about trade agreement. This is a topic which we went over in our general trade system guide, where we said that the income from trade links will increase by a huge margin when you make a trade agreement. Same is for merchants when they are trading and monopolizing the resources in the settlements. So trade agreement is a must as well if you want to trade in one faction's region. So to explain this, let me give you an example here. Currently, this merchant is making a total income of 25 denarii per turn, and we don't have a trade agreement with Salamis. So let's go and let's make a trade agreement with the Egyptians. Income is 250 denarii per turn for this merchant, which have two finances only. This is a huge increase, and it will stack up as you get monopolization and as they improve their settlement. Now we come to the mechanic of monopolization. As it states here under this tab for the merchant, it states that agent is monopolizing purple dye. This basically means that he is locking this resource for anybody else who will come to this island to trade, so they will not have access to this resource. However, that is not the only thing which monopolization does. The second thing, and one which is much more important, is that while you are monopolizing and when you are using the merchant and you are working on a resource, you have a chance of increasing the trade of this merchant, and this trade will exponentially increase the income which he is making. So you have to be on resource and monopolize the resource in order to boost up your merchant and to lock that resource for others when they come. So we have fast forwarded to this stage, and our merchant has three finances, and we can already see the increase in denarii per turn. This is a lower number now, just because this is basically a starting amount of finances which merchants have, and our merchant is really bad. However, as time passes and he fills up this bar, our merchant can make several thousand denarii per turn. Thank you guys for staying till the end. Now, I want to recommend you to check our trading guide, because it is essential for this guide. And also, please check the top 10 settlements in Rome Remaster for making ducats. Thank you guys, and bye.